what were the biggest challenges and the creative inspirations you had for this beautiful piece of set design you did?
Well, I have been working with Lindsay Turner over a period of years now, so she and I have a language, so we got going pretty fast. We knew what we wanted to say. We had Benedict, whose voice resonates from his back. I sat behind him at the first read-through. So we had him as an inspiration. What we hadn't really bargained for was how scrutinized we would be in the public eye and how much our work would be judged before it was ready. So that was really tricky. And it made me realize how privileged we normally are to have this period of previews where we're allowed to play with the audience, play with our ideas and experiment. And this time we weren't. We were judged on the first preview with a 2-star review, which was pretty upsetting. So I'm deeply delighted that the audience voted for this, because I think the audience was one of the most fantastic things about the whole experience. That particular audience, I've got to say, they're almost like the kind of audience I get at my rock shows when I do a Kanye West tour, or an audience that turns up only with good intention and not prepared to judge. So,
I mean, given that very unfair early negativity, how satisfying was it when everything was fully polished and the ghost and everything really came to life in the most wonderful ways?
It was, actually. Do you know, my favourite night was when I came to the NT Live recording and I watched the first half of the show in the cinema. Then at the interval, I went and watched the rest in the theatre. And that was, you know, spectacular. So,
obviously, Ben up for Best Actor as well tonight. What makes him such a unique and such a magical performer, particularly in live theatre?
Benedict Cumberbatch, I think about him that he has this ridiculous mind, ridiculously analytical mind, and at the same time is prepared to let it go. So you get that combination of ridiculous intelligence and then letting that all go on instinct on the night. And I think the audience can smell that a mile off. There's a moment in the play where Anastasia Hiller, as his mother, as Gertrude, comes to mop his brow while he's in the middle of the fencing match towards the end of the show. And the audience all just kind of go, oh, like that. They all want to be his mum. They all want to be his mum. So, yeah, it's a special connection he has.